try to do that as well, but that's usually more at like 9, so hopefully y'all are still sober enough to not try that. As a general rule of thumb, keep your body inside cold. That's what we're all about. Alright. This is also a great time. You can feel that we're picking up speed here. You can feel that wind blowing across your head. This is a good time to secure your belongings. Hats, wigs, fleece, toupees, eyelashes, things that could fly away and have flown away. I lost a hat just the other day. I saw a girl lose a flip flop. Whatever it could be, you know? Keep your belongings tightly planted somewhere. Especially baseball hats. Those are the worst ones. Sometimes if you treat it the other way, it becomes like more aerodynamic. Less likely to fly away. I don't know. Do what you will. That's your warning. Alright, I'm gonna give y'all a real quick life jacket demonstration because the Coast Guard requires it. I don't know what y'all came here to see. Thank you. Look at that. That's not bad, right? Feel good?
Yeah.
All right. So welcome here to the southern side of Chicago City Tour of the Waterton Tennis. All right, first and foremost, if you look to your left here, there's this green area with a bunch of buildings built in there. That Mayor's Museum campus, we like to keep all of our museums in that same little simple-ass area. Some good efficient learning while you're here in Chicago. First, we got this guy here on the far left. It's got that strange fan-like thing there and the dome top. That there is the planetarium. That's Adler Planetarium. That's the very first planetarium in the Western Hemisphere, especially enough. Right now it's under construction, but they are coming back to give you the best star viewing experience of your life. Alright, and if we look a little to the right, there's those glass round looking building. It's kind of big, spaceship-ish. That is where the Bears play. Any Bears fans? Woo! Right on. Just to the right of that field, we've got Shedd Aquarium. That is the smaller building with the white main area and the green tinted windows. Home to a lot of really cool fish. And a really good dolphin show, and also some penguins apparently, so a lot of fun stuff in there. We actually have to import all of our water from Florida, since we can't just put salt in a freshwater lake and hope for those fish to survive. So, we took it all in by about 90 million tons. Right behind Shedd Aquarium, we do have the Field Museum, home to a lot of really cool bones. We got any dinosaur fans on board? Okay. They have the most put together T-Rex in the entire world. Her name is Sue. She's pretty cool. Go by and say hi to Sue. Right ahead of us and a little to the right, we have the building you all came to see today. It's that black one. It goes up real tall. It stair steps up with the two antennas. I think I heard someone say it up front. Sears Tower.
Oh, yeah.
The Sears Tower. Some folks call it the Willis Tower, but they would be incorrect. So, Sears Tower it is. That is there is the tallest building in the North America, second tallest in the world, tallest in Chicago, of course. It was the tallest in the entire world for 25 years until it got beat out, but, you know, still a pretty cool building. I'm into it. They also have a fun balcony up there made of glass. You can walk out there, see all the people below you, the city, everything like that. It's also the highest woman's toilet in the world. Yeah, there you go. Still got it right.
Let's go.
welcome to the north side of your Chicago Skyline tour. Before we lose sight of it, everybody look to your right. There's a strange building, a mysterious building out there in the lake. What do y'all feel about that?
Pretty weird.
That's where we get all our water from in Chicago, actually. Quebec, our water intake crew sucks all the water from in there, and then it goes through the pipe, under the ground, under the lake, all the way back to this building. It's kind of squat and next to the Ferris wheel on the right-hand side of the light and the white stack. That is where it gets processed. Around a 20-hour sort of a situation from the middle of the lake to your faucet at home. So, locally sourced water, you know, we're all about that these days, huh? Alright, right ahead of us, a little bit to the left here, we've got this tall building with the two antennas on top. Y'all see that one yet? That is the John Hancock building. It is the fifth tallest in Chicago, but it used to be the first tallest for quite a while. You know, the technology improves, everyone wants to be the tallest, new buildings were built. But it's also a haunted building. I don't know if y'all believe in this touch ghost-like thing. Alright, I'll tell you the story anyway. So, the ground that building was built on used to be occupied by one man named Cap Streeter and quite a few of his friends. They hung out there, and not quite legally, one would say, but city council eventually said, hey, y'all gotta get out of here, we gotta build a building. They said, no, absolutely not. They ended up getting into a bit of a battle, and Cap Streeter ended up getting killed. And in his dying breath, he used it to curse that ground that the building was then built on. I will let you all look up the mysterious building, the mysterious stuff that has happened in John Hancock building on your own time. I don't want to scare anybody. But it was the inspiration for a little movie we would call Ghostbusters. Yeah! they ended up actually filming Ghostbusters in New York City. They missed out. They should have come to here. That was way cooler. They also got some good tourist stuff up there. Anyone done the tilt yet? Oh, some brave folks. Okay, alright. So the tilt's kind of a crazy thing where you hold on to essentially a glass wall and then you tilt forward at a 45 degree angle and it kind of feels like you're falling onto the city. You see everything below you. It's some really good views. You can see about four states from up there. I have a fear of heights, so too much for me, but if you're looking for something a little more chill, they got the observation deck on the next level right below it. You can see all the same views, but without the thrill of the tilt. And then right below that, if you're over the age of 21, they have the signature cocktail lounge. See all those same views and the price of a cocktail. So, good insider stuff there. Alright, y'all ready to go fast again?
Yes.
Whoa. Okay, faster. Alright, we'll see. our building facts. Alright, so first and foremost, Dave is here. Y'all know the one. That's the one you had to get on to get to us. Navy Pier was named after, as you may have guessed, the Navy. The Navy used it as a naval base back in World War I and then again in World War II. Navy Pier's changed a lot since those days. Now it's kind of more of an entertainment type area. But there is one thing that has not changed, and it's this structure right on the end, recognize those American flags with the green dome on top. That there's a ballroom. It has always been a ballroom. Everyone always wants to have a dance no matter the time period. I think they've actually got a volleyball tournament going in on it.
No, wait, right now.
Yeah,
no.
That's what's happening? Alright, okay, yeah. Volleyball folks. Hope y'all did well.
Ooh.
Right behind that there ballroom, there are some white tents on that roof. That there is offshore, Chicago's largest rooftop bar. That's pretty fun. Right below it is the beer garden. I know they just started playing some live music. So go ahead and feel free to check that out. I would recommend the walk up there. Even if you're not over the age of 21, you can go out, dance in the front yard, and see what's going on there.
The trip.
or you learn something about the city that you didn't know before. Camille will be standing at the back near the boarding room. She would love to hear what you guys thought of this trip. If you enjoyed it, let her know. Especially, you can throw her a handshake, a high five, a fist bump, an elbow bump. If you're feeling generous, she doesn't just hit you. Toss her a couple of bucks on your way.